Sometimes we can be a bit simplistic about the losses that people experience. We can think that the only factor that determines one experience of loss is the associated event. For example, when we hear that someone has had their driver's license cancelled, we would expect there to be a significant sense of loss associated with this event. Certainly, we would expect a greater experience of loss with this event than if the event was, say, the theft of $20. Of course, if the event in question was the serious illness of a loved one, then we would expect the sense of loss to be greater. We develop a sort of grief scale. If event A happens, then so much loss will be experienced. If event B happens, then a different amount of loss is experienced, and so on. For example, imagine three men, David, Barry, and Greg. All have their driver's licenses cancelled. In David's life, he hardly has to drive at all, but Barry and Greg need their driver's license for their employment. As well, for Greg, being able to drive is a significant identity issue. So for David, there's very little sense of loss in having his license cancelled. For Barry, he's shaken at the thought, but for Greg, he's absolutely devastated. So we can see very clearly that the event does not equal the loss. The loss equals the event, plus the life situation, and plus the personal issues. This complexity of losses challenges us to listen very carefully to the diversity of losses we can experience and speak about. Also, this complexity shows us how dangerous it is for us to think that since I've gone through an event that's similar to another person's event, I now know the losses that this person is now experiencing. Even if we have gone through a similar event, our life situations and who we are as people are different, and so our loss experience will be different. So to help us see and hear the complexity of losses that people can experience, including ourselves, I said in a previous video that we could say that there are four general types of losses that people can experience. As with the four basic emotions, mad, bad, sad, and glad, not only will their intensity vary from one person to another, but the number of losses being experienced will also vary. Remember, for our general losses, we use the acronym FIRM. Functional, not being able to do what they normally can. Identity, thoughts and image of myself, my world, my future no longer seem to be true. Relational, relationships are less than what they were. And material, well, the loss of possessions, including financial losses as well. So going back to our example, let's look at Greg, who was absolutely devastated when he lost his driver's license. Functional loss? Yep. Greg will not be able to get around as easily as he has in the past. This will mean that many basic life events will no longer take place or happen at all. Identity loss? Yep. So you see, Greg's a bit of a rev head. He's always enjoyed driving and technically can handle a car very well. Not being able to drive is like having a significant part of him removed. It seems to Greg that he's no longer whole. Relational loss? Yep, Greg's girlfriend lives a few suburbs away. He'll not be able to see her so often. When she does drive them someplace, they both get very stressed. Material loss? This as well. See, Greg had to change jobs now. His pay is less, and he's discovering that taxis are not cheap. See, generally we think the helpful thing to do when someone mentions a loss is to mention something positive. We think that if we feed back the loss, this will only push the person into a pit of despair or push them further down into their pit and somehow make things worse. But it's not so. The person's already in their pit. What you make clear with your positive comment is that you don't understand them. And most likely you're finding it uncomfortable to be with them in their pit. You intentionally or unintentionally minimize their sense of loss. You see, it's only when we feed back their loss, which is often stating how important what they lost actually is, that the person will for themselves draw upon the internal resources that they already have. Often this can mean that they will think of some positive perspectives themselves.